Hello again. This is Professor Jari Porras from the Lund University and Erasmus Mundus Master's Program Software Engineers for Green Deal. This time, I will be explaining you a bit of the role of ICT or information communication technologies in sustainable development. The role of ICT has been increasing during the last few years, largely due to the digitalization and due to the increased use of services. When we are talking about the ICT, we should note that we mean both hardware and software. We should also consider that when we are looking at the sustainability effects of ICT, those can be both negative and positive. The negative ones are usually called as a footprint of the ICT, and the positive ones as a handprint of the ICT. We should also consider that these effects can be visible at different times. There can be direct or immediate effects, while others may be indirect or enabling effects, and finally structural or so-called systemic effects. But more about these on the next slide. What we should also understand is the sustainability effects are not always only environmental. We should consider at least the economic and social effects in addition to the environmental effects when considering the sustainability and sustainability effects of ICT. This is one of my favorite pictures of the role of ICT in sustainable development. This is from the book of Hilde and Habischer, ICT Innovation for Sustainability, and it shows nicely both the footprint and handprint part of the ICT. The footprint, where the ICT is a part of the problem when we are using resources to create the hardware and software as well as services. And then there is the handprint part, where the ICT is a part of solution, where we are using the ICT for solving some other problems. We can also see in this particular picture the different levels of effects, direct effects, enabling effects, and systemic effects. Or if you are looking at the left side of this picture, the first level is basic technology. The second level is when we are applying the technology on different domains. And finally, the third level is that when we have been applying the application on some certain level, that changes the behavior and can cause some structural changes to our society. You might have heard of these two different terms, green IT and green by IT. Green IT is usually meaning something that we are doing things more efficiently. When we are adding the term green in front of something like green IT, it means that we are making it use less resources to produce less carbon footprints and so on. And then there is the other side, where we are talking about these enabling effects and systemic effects, where we are kind of achieving the green by IT or through IT. When we use the IT solutions to make other fields more efficient and help them to minimize their carbon footprint. Very good set of articles related now to this other fields and how we can use IT for improving the sustainability is provided by Global E-Sustainability Initiative by these two most recent articles or white papers, Smarter 2030, ICT Solutions for the 21st Century Challenges, and Digital with Purpose, Delivering a Smarter 2030. The Smarter 2030 shows you a set of different application fields and the possible effects of ICT on those. I truly recommend everybody to look at this thing. You might find out some nice ways of using ICT to achieve some sustainability effects. And then there is the second article quite recently published Digital with Purpose, Delivering a Smarter 2030, that looks at the digitalization processes and how we can use those for delivering actually those things that we promised or they promised in the previous document. In the Smarter 2030 article, it shows quite nicely how ICT emissions, you have to understand that here we are mainly talking about the ICT emissions or carbon emissions of ICT and comparing things on that. If we want to look at the social or economical aspects or effects, then we need to look, make other kind of calculations than what they have been providing here. this picture on the right side shows you three different parts of the emissions, what is causing the emissions. It basically shows the end-user devices, smartphones, tablets, PCs, etc., whatever the end-users are actually using. Then there is the data centers that is basically the other end of those services. Usually services are implemented in some cloud services that are then run on some data centers. And of course, these data centers, when you are running those things, you have servers and you have the computing units and data processing units and data communication units. You need some electricity. And as such, there is some emissions. And in between the end user device and data centers, we have the networks, wireless, home, enterprise, whatsoever network you might use. But anyway, you use some electricity for transferring your data from your end user device to the data center, to the service, and then back. Or through end user device, through the network to the other end user device. This is, although these emissions are kind of hardware based, software can have its role in decreasing these emissions. For example, routers or base stations. You can make more efficient algorithms to save energy on a base station. And as such, we can think about this as a possibility for green ICT. If we think about calculating the footprint for the software as such, that is more difficult because you always have some kind of a context for the software. There is a good article by Ahmed et al., a review of mobile application energy profiling, taxonomy, state of the art, and open research issues that has been published some time ago. That shows some of the difficulties in this footprint calculation for the software. But that is an emerging challenge that we will definitely tackle in this program. If looking at the footprint and handprint of the ICT. Here is a comparison. On the left side, there is a picture with a comparison of the ICT footprint and the ICT handprint. So the ICT footprint, this shows basically three different reports of the Global Sustainability Initiative. Smart 2020 was published already in 2008. And as such, it's the oldest one of these reports, and it shows that the ICT footprint was 1.46 gigatons CO2 emissions, whereas the handprint to ICT enabled reductions of carbon emissions is 7.8. That shows 5.5 times or multiplied reductions compared to the footprint as such. And if you go to the newest version of this report, Smarter 2030, that I was already recommending you, we can see that the ICT footprint has reduced a bit from the first one. That is partly because we have used the green IT or green ICT approach. We have making the IT technology more efficient, new algorithms, new ways of saving energy, and so on. But at the same time also, we have increased the possibilities of using the ICT for reducing. And the Smarter 2030 report shows already 9.7-fold decrease of the 9.7-fold decrease of the CO2 emissions between the handprint and the footprint. The lower picture here shows you different kind of application fields for the ICT. Mobility, that means basically personal mobility, logistics, and so on, has possibility of reductions for 3.6 gigatons of CO2 emissions. Manufacturing, agriculture, buildings, energy sector, and so on. Altogether, they calculated that there is a possibility for 12.1 gigatons of CO2 emissions by using ICT on 8 different fields. And we are definitely not limited to only these 8 fields that have been presented in the Smarter 2030 report, but we can always try to utilize the ICT and digitalization in any field that we see important. So, our program, Software Engineers for Green Deal, has definitely a software emphasis, but that doesn't mean that we fully omit the hardware issues. Whenever we are running the software, we are developing the software, we need to take the context into account. And even if we have the software emphasis, we may still consider sustainability in or off the software, meaning the green software part. That is the emphasis of the second semester of SE4GD program. And then there is the sustainability through software that we can definitely apply the software in different application fields to get those reductions of emissions. And we are not only talking here about the environmental effects, but we are also considering the economic and social effects when we are considering the sustainability of those solutions, what we are designing. Our program emphasizes both local and global challenges, solutions to those challenges, and finally, the impacts of the solutions. We are open to all application domains, from agricultural development to industrial efficiency, from private to public sector. And we definitely deal with all kinds of development, from individual growth to social change.